Emily Barlow Creations. If you're new to my channel and you're stopping by for the first time, thank you for stopping by. Welcome to my channel. Stick around a while by clicking that red button for more crafting on a budget, more everything on a budget videos to come. And if you click it again when the bell appears, YouTube should notify you every time I'm uploading a new video, depending on the option you choose in the drop-down menu of the bell. If you're interested in following me on social media, those links are in the description box below. What have I got going on for you for today? Today, I am bringing to you a Walmart DIY. This DIY, I gotta tell you, I am so stinking excited about. It was one that just kinda hit me when I was walking in Walmart. I saw this piece and I instantly was inspired and had to pick one up and bring it to you all. What am I bringing to you today? I am bringing to you a bleak to chic, or a transformation of this tombstone. This is a foam tombstone that you can get at Walmart right now because it is Halloween decor, $4.98. When I saw this, I saw that they had several different styles. This one style in particular caught my eye and I knew that this was something that I could transform into a decor piece that I could keep up in my house year round. And for the bargain price of under $5, you can't beat that. Plus, I will be using some items that I have in my stash, such as paint and whatnot. This is such a budget-friendly DIY, you're not gonna wanna miss this. So let's not waste any more time. Let's jump into it and let me show you what I have in mind for this Halloween tombstone that you can get at Walmart for $4.98. Let's get to it. Walmart had several different designs in these tombstones for $4.98. Great buy. I love how distressed it is. I think that this is gonna work to my benefit later on. I also really loved the design in the top here in the center. What I wasn't super excited about was the wording, "I'm gone." I'm not quite sure where I'm gonna go with this DIY yet, so I knew that I needed to probably disguise this somehow. I'm gonna do that using the Spackling by Toolbench that I got from the Dollar Tree a while ago. This is something that I've had in my stash that comes in handy sometimes in DIYs like this. I'm gonna take my finger, nothing fancy, and I'm gonna fill in all of the letters with the spackling. Once I've got it completely filled in, I'm gonna let this dry for just a couple of hours. This spackling dries pretty quickly. When you're applying this, you don't want it to be level. You kind of want it to be elevated because you really don't want any sign of the lettering. If you want to use a putty knife, you can. I just found that it was a lot easier to use my finger and I didn't want to take the chance in scratching the foam with a putty knife. And so I figured just all in all, using my fingers to fill in these letters was probably the best route to go. I'm not gonna fill in the cracks because I really like the look of them. If the cracks are too much for you, now would be a good time when having this putty out to fill in these cracks too if you want more of a smoother look to your cross, I'm gonna call it. Once the spackling is good and dry, you can tell it's dry because it really gets a bit hard. I'm gonna take a rougher sandpaper and I'm really gonna just sand down the areas that I applied the spackling. I really wanna focus on those outside edges though, because you want there to be kind of a smooth transition from the tombstone to the spackling. You don't want that defined edge so you can actually tell that there was spackling put there. I'm not real worried about making it super smooth because the tombstone itself is a bit on the rougher side. And so I think just by smoothing out the outside edges of it is gonna be enough. Now, because I don't seem to have any gray paint on hand, and that is the color that I wanted to use for this DIY, I'm gonna make do with what I have by using this Apple Barrel white and black matte acrylic paint. I'm gonna start off by pouring a generous amount of the white paint on this plate. Then little by little, I'm gonna add the black paint to the white, mixing it till I achieve the gray that I'm looking to achieve. I really wanted to use Waverly's Elephant, which is a real nice gray. It's kind of a medium gray. And so I think I can easily achieve that just by adding the black paint to the white. And so I decided that I'm gonna just kind of do a big batch of this paint because I don't know how many coats I'm gonna need for this DIY. And I don't wanna have to go back and remix this paint trying to get the color that I made initially. So if you just kind of make a bigger batch, You don't have to worry about color matching later. And if you make too much and you want to save it, you can always put it in one of Dollar Tree's reusable containers and save it for a later date. I'm going to give this tombstone a nice thick base coat of this gray paint. If your preference isn't that of using a matte paint and you like to use a gloss or a satin paint, you totally can do that. It really is your preference and your choice. I personally just feel like a gloss or a satin finish doesn't give the feel or vibe of that rustic feel. And so I prefer the matte. And in general, I'm just not a shiny paint type person anyway. So I kind of prefer those duller finishes. But like I said, it really is your DIY. So make it your own and do it to suit your decor needs with what you like. Now, because this is foam and it's probably not gonna fit in my oven, I'm gonna stick this outside and let it get good and dry. It ended up taking about a half an hour to 45 minutes to completely dry because it's not super hot outside. So that really was the only time-consuming part of this DIY. Once my tombstone is good and dry, I'll be using Waverly chalk paint in the color of ivory. And yes, this is foil on the top of it because I somehow threw the lid away, bummer. I'm gonna give the lower areas of this tombstone a dry brush stroke over the gray with the ivory paint. I wanna be real light with the brush. I don't want any heavy coverage. And I'm just gonna kinda go over the lower areas. I'm not gonna fill in the cracks of the tombstone with the white. I think that the darker those cracks are, it'll make them stand out a bit more. I'm not gonna go over the center embellishment because this is gonna be a different color. I just kinda wanna use this Waverly as an accent, giving it that stone look, letting the gray kinda peek through that ivory paint. Now, using one of my all-time favorite colors by Waverly, this agave, this color is gorgeous. This is one of those colors that works so nicely in a farmhouse DIY. And so I thought that this color would be perfect to accent the center embellishment. And I'm only gonna put this color on the elevated areas of this center embellishment, really just to accent it. I still want the gray to show behind it. I still want that white ivory color to be there. And that ivory white color is really just gonna make this agave blue kind of pop even more. So once I've got this whole center embellishment outlined in this agave, I'm gonna take my Waverly paint, the ivory, and I'm gonna just kind of go along this center ditch here. You can see how there's just this kind of groove here, and I'm gonna just kind of use this to accent this blue even more. I think that just by adding the white here, it's gonna draw your eye more to the center of this DIY, which is what I wanna do. Once I'm completely done painting, I'm gonna take a real light sandpaper and I'm gonna go over all of the areas that I dry brushed the ivory paint on. By doing this, it's gonna soften up the look of the ivory. It's also going to bring in some of the gray that I covered up. I want to distress this just a bit more. It's also gonna help get rid of any of the brush strokes that there may or may not be from using the dry brush technique on this. And so you don't wanna rub real hard because this is foam and you don't wanna go all the way through the gray to the original design, but you can see that just by lightly sanding over this, it's really softening up that white. It's giving a more age rustic feel and it's bringing back some of the gray paint as well. Now, this would not be one of my farmhouse creations if I did not somehow incorporate burlap or twine or maybe even both. Today, I am using one of these burlap rolls that you can get at Walmart for about $2, and it's a pretty good size roll. I cut about a 20-inch piece, and I folded it so both ends of the burlap meet underneath, if that makes any sense. Then using a piece of twine, I'm gonna place it in the middle of my burlap, and by simply tying it, it's gonna pull your burlap together in the shape of a bow. But what you wanna make sure of is that those outside edges of your burlap, that you fold them out. This is gonna help so your bow lays nicely and actually looks like a nice bow. For the tails of the bow, I'm gonna cut 2 12-inch pieces of burlap as well. I'm going a bit on the longer side because I really don't know how long I want these tails to be. To give these tails the illusion that they're actually tied in with the bow, if you accordion fold the top edge, I'm using hot glue. This is optional. You don't have to do this step if you don't want to. I'm gonna hot glue each of the flaps, then I'm gonna take a piece of twine and I'm gonna tie it around this top edge and just tie it off to really hold it in place. I'm gonna do that to both of these tails. Using some hot glue on the back side of the bow, I'm just gonna hot glue these right to that bottom edge of the bow. On the back side, this is what you're gonna see and this is what you should be left with. I wanted to add a bit of color to the burlap bow. When I saw this chevron print and the blue agave print, I knew that this was perfect, that this would tie the bow in with the center of this cross. So I cut an 8-inch piece of this burlap, I folded it in half, then using a bit of hot glue on the ends of the inside, I'm gonna hot glue the ends together. Be sure not to put any glue in the center of this because we're gonna accordion fold this to make it a bow. And I'm gonna hold this together by tying a piece of twine around the center. And because I had this bundle of raffia left over from a previous DIY, I figured I'd incorporate it into this bow. We all know that raffia is really hard to work with. If you wet it just a bit, it makes it manageable, it straightens it out, it's easy to work with. Raffia is such a beautiful addition to so many farmhouse DIYs, but sometimes it can be a drawback. You don't really want to work with it because it's unruly, unmanageable. Just wet it and it is so manageable. It's so easy to work with. I'm going to fold my raffia in fours just like so. Then I'm going to take and I'm going to place it in between my burlap bow and my chevron bow. To hold these together, I figured I'd use a strip of burlap, wrap it around the center and just hot glue it to the back. Once I've trimmed up my raffia, I'm gonna take and separate the strands. You can easily just kind of pull them apart or tear them apart, and this is gonna kind of just fill it out more, give you more strands of raffia, kind of the fun of working with it, I guess. Because I only placed burlap in the center of this bow, I'm gonna put just a bit of hot glue under this chevron bow just to keep the raffia in place. And I'm thinking the perfect spot for this bow is right below that center embellishment of this cross. What's really great about these tombstones is that they were intended for Halloween yard art, so they came with these plastic stands that go right at the bottom of this. So if you want this cross to stand up somewhere in your house, you can replace these and they'll stand up. If you wanna hang this, I would just flip it over and on the back here, hot glue some twine from side to side, and because it's so light, it'll easily hang up. And would you look at that? I took a piece that I'm gonna call was Halloween bleak, and I turned it into something that I think is so farmhouse chic, I can hardly stand it. This is most definitely a piece that can be left up in your house year round and is a piece that is gonna leave people talking and asking you where you got it from. I am so obsessed with this piece that I went back to Walmart. I picked up more of these because I definitely think that these are great gift ideas this Christmas. I hope you all enjoyed today's video and I inspired you to go out and get one of these foam tombstones and transform it to suit your decor. This can easily be made to suit any decor style just by changing up the paint, adding some rhinestones, using your creative mind and making it your own. It doesn't have to be just the farmhouse decor. Please make sure to give this video a thumbs up and let's get this video to 5,000 likes. Each and every one of those thumbs up, they really do help my channel to grow and it helps YouTube to notice me a bit more along with those comments in the comments section. Until next time, everybody, I hope you have a fantastic day. Happy crafting on a budget and bye for now, everybody.